you just anoint this afternoon, this service, yes. Father God, that everyone who enters, Father God, be glorified and praised for the hell of here today, Father God. Yes. Therefore, Father, we just ask right now that you just have your way in this place, Father God. Yes. We ask the Holy Spirit just to invoke this place, Father God, just invoke your sweet spirit that rises up to sweetness, to nostrils, to your ears, to your nose, Father God. We just pray, Father God, right now that you will just touch every heart here, Father God, that when we leave, we'll leave just a little bit happier. If you came in with a burden, Father God, we ask right now that that burden be lifted because of what goes on here, Father God. If you're discouraged, we ask, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, that when we leave here this afternoon, we'll have joy. This is not part because of, we know that you are the strength of our lives, Father God. So, Heavenly Father, we just ask right now, we dedicate this service to you, to your glory, to your honor, to your praise, because you are so worthy. Yes. We give you the glory, honor, and praise in your precious Son, Jesus' name. We pray you all thanks. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. What a wonderful prayer. Congregation, we just want to open it now. Is there anybody who has something on their heart? They want to say, maybe they have a testimony that we lift somebody else up. If there's a song on your heart that you want to sing, we're here to worship with you. We certainly will back you up in this. Anybody have a song on their heart, a testimony they want to share?
You ought to take the Lord with you here and now.
Street. what your purpose is, because we all know that there are people that have a lot of heart conditions, and I'm thankful that I don't.
Amen.
That's another reason to praise God.
Amen.
That's another reason to praise God, and I just, you know, stand here to say that I love the Lord so much.
Amen.
I love my Father so much. It was a great service today in Clinton Tabernacle.
Amen.
Yeah.
You know, our youth are going through some tough times. Times when we came through, there were somebody in the community going to look out for you, going to watch your back, going to make sure that something was going on for you. We have youth now stepping out and they don't know what they're going to do with their lives because the job situation the way it is, if you don't get the higher education, if you don't get this, if you don't get that, it's so hard for them. And we just want to keep them in prayer all the time. We love our youth, and let's just wrap our arms around them and let them know how much we care and try to support them in any way we can.
Amen.
And on that note,
he's an on time.
Oh.
minds and hearts are clear. We'll move well on in the service. But now listen to me, if you have a testimony, you just got a song in your heart. You got a faith speech. Come quick, we're gonna do it. We're still gonna do it. We're gonna leave nobody out there, all right? But if that's it, we're gonna move forward on in the service. Everyone stand, please. I was glad when he said to me, let us come into the house of the Lord. We're going to sing hymn, Blessed Quietness, page 130. Blessed Quietness, page 130.
Different today. And it reads, my children, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened, so that you may know what is the hope of his calling, what are the glorious riches of his inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power to us who believe according to the working of his vast strength. Many of us have been in our church for so long, we never really question whether or not we believe in God. Of course, we do. Why else would we be here? But there do come times when we wonder, for example, when we hear all the different religious beliefs and practices operating in our world, we wonder how that could possibly be just one way among all the others held so deeply by so many. When we think of a dear friend who is such a good person, but just can't understand why a relationship with Christ should matter in her life. We wonder if our faith is built on anything more than the way we grew up, or when we get into discussions with people who know we're Christians, who ask us those, what do you think about questions, that paint us into a corner and make us sound self-proved and narrow. We wonder if it's just us or our beliefs that have grown tired and dry. But there's one place where deaths go to die, and you're no more than a page turn from being there. The Bible is an anchor of truth in a sea of deception. We can't go to the movie store. We can't go to the health club. We can't go to work. We can't go down the street without running head on into deceptive images and ideas. Do this, be that, think this, try that, go here, go there. What for? Why not? It's everywhere. Lies, untruth, deception.
Right.
Even inside our own homes. Even inside our own hearts. But it doesn't have to be. Because we can open the Word. We can dive in there and swim around in truths that have preserved God's people for generations. We can turn from one book to the next and discover passages and insights we've never even noticed before. We can find it to be as fresh as the question we were asking ourselves just the other day, yet as long-lasting as the verse we remember learning from our childhood. We can read it and we can live it. Some people read their Bible like they're taking a dose of medicine, checking it off their calendar and not thinking about it yet again until tomorrow. The scripture says they are not people who look at themselves in the mirror before they leave the house. But when they get out into the real world, they can't remember what they look like. They're human dressed that a hair might be out of place, a blood stain might have gotten on their clothes, a noticeable flaw might have come unmasked without their knowing. But when the Bible is not food and drink, when it's not just words to think about, but words to feel about, we can mark the commonness into our day. We can spot deception for what it is. We can know whom we may have believed. And be conceived that its truth will keep us pure and protected in every stage of life. The question is not whether our minds are open or not. The question is whether our Bibles are.
Amen. Amen.
Dear celebrities, hold on.
Missionary Baptist Church. Shortly after his arrival, the Soul Stirrers Spiritual Chorus was formed with 11 members. Our founder was Sister Beatrice Mama B. Roberts. As the years passed, the chorus grew. In the early years, the chorus presented two popular musical plays, The Old Ship of Zion and The Way of the Cross. The duties of the chorus include singing on the seventh Sunday for church services and during covenant meetings, revivals and other functions when requested by the pastor. We would like to thank Sister Josephine James and Sister Ruth Morgan for their many years of dedication to the choir. We also wish our Sister Elaine Lisbon well as she continues to get better. Have a good evening.
Somewhere morning, when this life is over, God, we thank you for the opportunity to give. We thank you for you said, given it shall be given to you. This yes. measure pressed down and shaken together. Thank you for each giver. Thank you for what you're doing and going to do in our lives. And God, be the glory in Jesus' name.
Heaven is my goal. go.
Heaven is my home.
Each and every day.
To heaven.
just about got it. Get that to me at the program. Somehow they done that. Everybody heard Sam Lewis again. Fly. Next on this song, Nobody Great. And then Sister Esther came back and sung, Lord, you the landlord. This old building is leaking. Lord, you the landlord. This old building is leaking. Y'all know how to say that. You got a landlord, park with a fixed pump. Sometimes park with a fixed roof. Sometimes park in a place, the window pane. But one thing about Jesus, the cancer person from Jackson, Mississippi say, fix it, Jesus, fix it. Like you said, you would. Yeah. And so if so Jesus had to do that, you fix that living deal. Then you sit here, fix it. Morning?
Yes.
And look, we have three groups. And what we have today, lots of gospel choir, we're going to be praying. Penn Tabernacle in Cherryville, North Carolina, Zion Hill, Jordanaires. And you in truth today. Take my word on that. Won't be two selections. But y'all, sometimes people like to say, a theme and two, I'm going to keep it real, stay true. Three songs, okay? Three songs. Three songs. All right, Pastor Gospel, are y'all on?
Oh. Lord, I Let's give Paul a hand, y'all. You know, something I think about, you know, when the Holy Spirit comes, it's like something in the inside, working on the outside. You can feel it burning, you know. Yeah. And it's telling me to go ahead, you know. And then it came to you, it's going to be a rapture. You know? And the dead in Christ shall rise. And every eye shall see him, you know. And we all going to Jesus. It's going to be a rapture. We've been looking for that rapture. And you know, when I think about it, you know, you look around, you think that you're in bad shape. You look around, you see people, you know, got authorized to get you, you can't walk. And you look around, you see nobody with no legs, and you see nobody who can't talk, and can't even see. You know, you guys have to say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
said he's wonderful, God. I didn't know how their life was going to turn out. But you started out trusting in God. Turned out all right, didn't it? We serve a good God.
Yes.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Salvation and glory. Thank you.
go up.
Yeah.
Blessings come down.
Yeah.
But some of us don't know that worship is even more powerful than prayer.
Amen.
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 In Revelation 19 and 1, it says, such that you, no matter what I have to do, can I tell you something I can do about that song? That's what I'm winning. Chasing. No matter what I had to do, I just kept on working. Just kept on working. And you have to be committed to it. And that's the same thing you have to do with God.
Amen.
Chasing after God, no matter what I have to do, what we talk about, I'm chasing anyway. Hell out and took me a trail. I'm chasing anyway. Amen. So understand that.
And we hope y'all have many more anniversaries.
Amen.
my new chair.
Got a good person. $2. And literally, you ain't paid. Stroke your feet, clap your hands. Somebody dress the table.
It's all
right. It's good, wasn't
it? Amen.
Amen. That's what I'm talking about. It's good to get out and celebrate the Lord. Amen. 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 So God is getting good to us. It was all up this morning.
Yes.
Thought all was on our way.
Yes.
Thought all was in the right mind.
Yes.
Gave all the leading force to help the spirit.
Yes.
God is good.
For this old house is gonna suit.
God.
Yes.
God is so good.
Yes.
It's not today or yesterday, all the time.
Yes.
And I tell my children so many times, I say, I'm by myself, but I'm blessed. The reason I'm by myself, all my friends and relatives that came up with me are gone. And the only thing that I have is my children and grandchildren. God is good, y'all. It wasn't what I did, it's what he did for us. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. And thank you.
Having a good time, and I got down there, they had all kinds. food. Everybody gonna start naming. And we ate so much, and they had the orchestra from LR. After then, they'd come in annually, and they were there, and they were playing. They were, give me mine, they were playing professionally. They sounded good. And I don't, and Sherby Jones not here, but I'm gonna tell you what I want to. She started, they called, pulled Miss Josephine James out of school, and she started dancing. And then they made me get on the floor with her. Amen. Amen. She can throw them elbows back to them. Me and Miss James, I cherish that, being able to dance to the LR Orchestra at the High House. Now, a little bit of a sweet news, they told me you have to be 55. I thought you had to be at least 70. And I found out that, well, praise God, this summer I will qualify to become one of them. July, I might as well go ahead and join them. Eat that good cooking and have some fun. Amen. Amen. It's all good. You can dye it and fry it or whatever, shave it. It's all right. Whatever floats your boat. Amen. Let us stand for any other person's remarks. Thank God for the musicians. Amen. Musicians, thank God for the audio video. Amen. Things just right. Amen. Let's look to God. Oh God, we thank you for this opportunity to come and worship you, to praise you and to magnify you. Oh God, you said you inhabit the praises of the saints. Thank you for each choir, for each church, for each person came to celebrate Jesus with the soul service. We give you praise, honor, and glory. Now we ask your blessings upon the refreshments that have been prepared downstairs. Oh God, that we may be sanctified for the strength and edification of our body. Bless our fellowship and friendship together till we meet again. It is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.